My name is Eddie San Juan, and I'm the back-end operations manager at EF San Juan Incorporated. We're a custom molding and millwork manufacturing company. We make doors, exterior, interior, windows, pretty much any product made out of wood. We had an aging Onsrud CNC, so it was with an OSAI controller, and really started to not necessarily go down completely, but when it would get cold, it would start to not start up. Extended periods of time where we'd have to start it 5, 6, 7, 8 times, and we started to get nervous. We ordered a new controller, not something that was currently made, so everything you were buying was refurbished. We got ours sent to us and it wasn't programmed, shipped it off multiple times, they even sent it to Italy to OSAI to actually do some reprogramming, got to us again, and this was like a 6-month process. And when we finally got that one back and it didn't work, I realized this could have been us down for 6 months. And that's when I immediately started looking for somebody that could place the processor, found MachMotion, and then started pursuing it. So I didn't have a time where the machine actually was down and we were totally incapacitated and waiting, but it was more of a preemptive measure.
So where this was real convenient for me to release a tool manually, a lot of times we had to get a second person to come in and catch it for us.
We'd been very strict on our maintenance of our routers over the years, so I knew that physically all of the nuts and bolts of our routers were in pristine shape and could still hold the tolerances that we needed. The only thing that was aging about our routers was the controller, the servos, and the electrical kind of heart of the machine. It's definitely a huge fear in any, you know, owner or management type scenario where you've got a machine that is a huge revenue producer for your company, and being down for 6 months, it's hard to even estimate what the opportunity cost would have been, let alone just the cost of having a machine not producing the parts.
From programming, it helps speed things up, makes it a little bit more efficient. A lot of it was just going through with the post-processor outputting to where they can see things easier. Everything works great. They can actually look through the program and see this part of the program does this, this part of the program does this, and actually communicate better between us and the operators.
The way you can actually just switch to the next tool that you want. We used to have to delete code out, and that put us in a bind of deleted something that was needed, you crash the machine, and now you can just skip to the next tool that you're actually wanting to be using.
The machine was operating, you know, and starting to do the calibration within 3 days, I believe, and then the next Monday we were running parts again. It was a 1 week downtime, and that's what we planned for, and it was executed. If you've got a machine that you've taken good care of and you are even a little bit paranoid about its ability to start up, its ability to get parts, its ability to get anything about the computer system within your router, I think one of these upgrades is a no-brainer. I mean, generally the cost is a fraction of what it takes to buy a brand new one, let alone the lead time it takes to get a brand new one. So all in all, I'd say it's better than I ever could have imagined it went. You know, it's a very complicated thing. I'm blown away by the experience, really. I'd recommend it to anybody that has a machine that's applicable and compatible with what you guys do.